Hi, I'm Marco Tangaro. I work for Elixir Italy, and here I'm going to present you the update of Laniakea. So, Laniakea is a Galaxy on-demand platform which is based on the Indigo Data Cloud bus layer, but also on many Galaxy project tools like the official Galaxy Docker container or Ephemeris, but also on common open source tools like Vault, Lux, Slurm, or Kubernetes, for example. A private cloud instance of Galaxy is recommended for those scenarios where the full administrative control of the instance is still needed, like for example training, tools development, or for example data privacy concerns. We provide also access to cloud resources to be used for the deployment of on-demand Galaxy instances through our pilot program, Laniakea Trekkers. We currently have about 20 running Galaxy instances, for example, some public servers like Vinyl, which was presented here like last year, Korgat, to align complete assemblies of SARS-CoV-2 genomes, or ETS1WB, which have been accepted for publication and is dedicated to global taxonomic analysis of eukaryotic communities. So, the service is commonly used for rapid development of bioinformatics tool, efficient delivery of training activities, and provision of public bioinformatics services. I would recommend you the poster of Pietro Mandrioli during the poster session on this topic. During this year, working side by side with researchers and clinicians, we learned a lot on our users' community and on our cloud providers. So, the development of the next release of Laniakea have been deeply influenced by our community requirements. In particular, at platform level, we need to update everything from Python 2 to Python 3, but also we need to update some important packages like Ansible. At service level, we need a new service level agreement and the user's quota management. At development level, we need to simplify the deployment strategy of Galaxy in order to reduce the maintenance effort. And finally, we have some requirements from our users like better container support and new applications. First of all, at bus level, we have this new service level agreement tool. A SLA is a commitment between a cloud provider, in this case GAR or Recas Bari for us, and a client, which in this case is of course Elixir Italy. And we need this to improve resource federation because we have many data centers in Italy and we want to use all these resources. And in this case, as you can see in the figure on the bottom, we will introduce also per group and quota management in terms of course of number of instances, RAM, CPU, and storage, which is now available in the current version only on, for example, OpenStack 11. For the Galaxy deployment, on Laniakea, you can deploy Galaxy using Ansible, so you have a virtual machine, and Ansible will install and configure everything for you. Or you can use a VM image. So you have this image with everything inside, you deploy it, and everything is working. This procedure has been simplified using CVMFS volume to store tools and Galaxy database down. So we deploy this image with Galaxy inside, we restore the Galaxy tool. Database, the tool are on CVMFS and everything is working. We also contextually update everything from Python 2 to Python 3. Finally, from the user feedback, we need to implement RStudio and Jupyter, and that now are available as a standalone application, but also integrated in Galaxy, and we are backporting these features to the current production version. And this has been requested for training and development, but also it was required us to support container because, for example, there is this RCask use case, which is a single cell RNA-seq workflow that is developed only using the Docker container. So we need to provide them enough resources, and we will do this with our Mesos or Kubernetes, which are both now available as out of the box. So we think this will be a great release of LaniaKea, which is expected to be published by the end of the year. And finally, I would just to thank you all for your attention.